Hello and welcome to our presentation of our study in evaluating virtual reality logomotion interfaces on collision avoidance tasks with a virtual character. Performing logomotion in virtual environments is challenging. Firstly, the virtual environment is most likely bigger in size compared to the real environment in which a user is located. Secondly, mismatches between the virtual and real-world obstacles are quite evident, which makes it difficult for a user to move around without colliding with real-world obstacles. To overcome these issues, locomotion interfaces that allow virtual reality users to navigate large virtual environments more efficiently have been developed over the past few years. In particular, through interfaces such as joysticks and techniques such as teleportation, allow users to navigate virtual environments. The self-motion experience of the user is limited. Thus, interfaces such as the omnidirectional treadmill and techniques such as redirected walking and walk in place enable users to experience walking in a virtual environment in a natural or an unnatural way while also overcoming the limits of physical space. For this study, we have considered prior work that has indicated that locomotion in virtual environments is a fundamental activity and that natural walking is considered to be the most realistic interface for walking in a virtual environment. Therefore, we have adapted natural walking as our baseline interface and we examine whether omnidirectional treadmill, walk-in-place and joystick interfaces can provide walking movement and experiences close to those of natural walking. In this study, participants were asked to perform a collision avoidance task with a virtual character that was standing at the midpoint between the starting and the ending positions, which is a common task that's performed by virtual reality users when experiencing virtual reality scenario or playing games. We collected avoidance movement measurements, including clearance distance, trajectory length, and trajectory curvature, and self-reported ratings including simulation sickness, usefulness, satisfaction, ease of use, and task load in order to evaluate the examined locomotion interfaces. To recapitulate, our study objectives were to investigate first whether avoidance movement differences exist across the four examined locomotion interfaces, and second, whether potential variations across the self-reported ratings of the locomotion interfaces could provide additional insights into user experience. In particular, our study attempts to answer the following research questions. How do omnidirectional treadmill, walk in place, and joystick compare to natural walking when participants perform an avoidance movement maneuver with a virtual character? How do participants evaluate their user experience across the examined interfaces? For this within group study, we conducted an a priori power analysis to determine the appropriate sample size. The calculation was based on 95% power, a medium effect size of 0.25. Four groups with four repeated measures, a repeated measures correlation of 0.50, a non-sphericity correction of 0.60, and alpha value of 0.05. The analysis resulted in a recommended sample size of 52 participants. We recruited 64 undergraduate and graduate students from our university. The participants were recruited through posters on campus, emails throughout the departments of the university, and in-class announcements. Participants provided informed consent in accordance with the Institutional Review Board of the Purdue University. No direct reward was given for participation. Of the sample, 21 were female and 43 were male. Moreover, 7 of the participants were experiencing virtual reality for first time, and all participants were experiencing virtual reality locomotion through the use of a treadmill for first time. Student ages ranged from 18 to 32, with a mean of 22.11. Also, students' height ranged from 158 to 202 centimeters, with a mean of 173.17 centimeters. The study was conducted in the virtual reality lab at Purdue University. A simple virtual environment, as shown in this figure, was designed in 3ds Max and was ported to a Unity game engine to approximate the size of the virtual reality lab. The exact same 3D model was used for all examined locomotion interfaces. A white and black indicator informed the participants of the starting and target positions. The participants had to avoid a virtual character placed at the midway point. To provide the participants with enough space and time to avoid the virtual character located midway, which shows a distance of 7 meters between the starting and target positions, based on assessments from a previous study. The virtual character used in the study and the idle motion sequence were downloaded from Adobe Mixamo. The virtual character was assigned an idle motion. No gazing of the virtual character at the body of the participants was implemented. Instead, the face of the virtual character was animated based only on the assigned idle motion. For this study, we used the HTC Vive Pro head-mounted display for projecting the virtual reality content. The HTC Vive wireless adapter was also used to transmit the visual content to the user during all examined interfaces, thereby eliminating any negative interference with human movement behavior that the cable of the head-mounted display might have produced when participants performed their avoidance movement task. Note that according to the HTC Vive, the wireless transmitter offers an in-zero latency. The Dell Alienware Aurora R7 desktop computer was used to run the application for all examined interfaces. Regarding the clearance measurement, we found significant results across the examined interfaces. Pairwise comparisons indicated that the mean clearance for the joystick interface was significantly lower than that for the natural walking, walk-in-place, and omnidirectional treadmill interfaces. Moreover, we found that the mean clearance of the natural walking and walk-in-place interfaces was significantly lower than that for the omnidirectional treadmill interface. The length measurement also gave significant results across the examined interfaces. The pairwise comparison showed that the mean length for the joystick interface was significantly lower than that for the natural walking, walk-in-place, and omnidirectional treadmill interfaces. We also found that the mean length for the natural walking interface was significantly lower than that for the omnidirectional treadmill interface and for the walk-in-place interface. Finally, we found that the mean length for the walk-in-place interface was significantly lower than that for the omnidirectional treadmill interface. The curvature measurement also provided significant results. Pairwise comparisons indicated that mean curvature for the omnidirectional treadmill interface was significantly higher than that for the natural walking interface, the walk-in-place interface, and the joystick interface. Moreover, the mean curvature of the walk-in-place interface was significantly higher than that for the natural walking. The figure of this slide illustrates the average trajectories performed by the participants for each locomotion interface. The gradient color of the trajectory denotes the distance between the participants and the virtual character. Green denotes the closest and red the furthest. The white indicator informed the participants of the starting position and the black indicator informed the participants of the target position. Regarding the simulation sickness, which is based on the SSQ questionnaire, we found significant effects across the examined interfaces. Pairwise comparisons indicated that the mean score for the joystick interface was significantly higher than that for the three other interfaces. Moreover, the mean SSQ score of the walk-in-place interface was significantly different than that for the omnidirectional treadmill and natural walking interfaces. The learning segment of the use questionnaire indicated significant effects across examined interfaces. Pairwise comparisons showed that participants rated the omnidirectional treadmill interface significantly lower than the natural walking, the joystick, and the walk-in-place interface. Moreover, our participants rated the walk-in-place significantly lower than the natural walking and the joystick interface. The usability ratings also showed some effects across examined interfaces. Pairwise comparisons indicated that the participants rated the omnidirectional treadmill interface significantly lower than the natural walking interface, the joystick interface, and the walk-in-place interface. By analyzing the efficacy rating once again, we found significant effects across the examined interfaces. Pairwise comparisons indicated that the participants rated the omnidirectional treadmill interface significantly lower than the natural walking interface, the joystick interface, and the walk-in-place interface. Similarly, regarding satisfaction ratings, we found significant effects across the examined interfaces. Pairwise comparisons indicated that the mean score of the omnidirectional treadmill interface was significantly lower than that for the natural walking, joystick, and walk-in-place interfaces. The collected NASA TLX data was analyzed to investigate the effort exerted and performance of participants. By analyzing the self-reported ratings, we found significant differences in the levels of physical demand across the examined locomotion interfaces. Pairwise comparisons show that the physical demand required during the omnidirectional treadmill interface is significantly higher than that for the walking place, the natural walking and joystick interfaces. The results also reveal that the joystick interface required significantly less physical demand than that for the natural walking and walking place interfaces. Finally, our data analysis also indicated a significant difference in the level of effort across examined locomotion interfaces. Pairwise comparisons showed that the physical effort required during the omnidirectional treadmill interface is significantly higher than that for the walking place, natural walking, and joystick interfaces. In this study, two goals were set. First, to assess the differences in performing a collision avoidance maneuver when encountering a virtual character across the examined four locomotion interfaces, and second, to subjectively evaluate the locomotion interfaces based on participants' feedback. Our analysis of the obtained data revealed some significant results concerning the way that our participants performed collision avoidance tasks across the examined locomotion interfaces. Our results indicated that all movement behavior measurements of the omnidirectional treadmill interface were significantly different compared to the rest of the examined locomotion interfaces. Moreover, some similarities were found across natural walking, walking place, and joystick for all the examined measurements. Although we were expecting significant results between the examined locomotion interfaces, we found these results interesting because they indicated that participants' avoidance movement behavior in a virtual environment relates closely to the interface being used to perform the avoidance movement maneuver. In addition to the objective measurements, we also collected subjective self-reported ratings to further evaluate the examined locomotion interfaces. The collected SSQ data concerning motion sickness revealed that participants rated the joystick interface higher than the other interfaces. This result reveals that near-walking interfaces such as omnidirectional and walking place affect the proprioceptive and vestibular cues of the participants in a way that could be considered close enough to the way that these cues are affected when exposed to natural walking. Thus, it could be said that more active locomotion interfaces reduce simulation sickness when compared to a passive interface such as the joystick. The data obtained from the use questionnaire also indicated that it was much easier for the participants to learn how the natural walking and joystick locomotion interfaces work than the omnidirectional treadmill and walking place ones. This was expected, the result, since the participants are exposed to natural walking and joystick interfaces more often and are thus more familiar with them compared to omnidirectional treadmill and walking place, which our participants do not get exposed as frequently. In terms of usability, efficacy and satisfaction, our participants indicated that the omnidirectional treadmill was the least easy to use, its output was not as expected, and the participants were less satisfied with it compared to the other examined interfaces. Taking together these findings are considered reasonable outcomes. As has been found in a previous study, the omnidirectional treadmill is a locomotion interface that requires more than the usual effort by the participants, and it does not output accurately enough the participants' movement intention. In this paper, we have evaluated four virtual reality locomotion interfaces in order to assess their differences when the participants were asked to perform an avoidance movement task with a virtual character. Although the examined locomotion interfaces and the virtual character that participants were instructed to avoid were restricted for experimental purposes, we deemed that the results obtained from the chosen interfaces provide valuable information to the research community. Please refer to our paper for more details about our study and results. Thank you for your attention.